I'm going to show you today how to do a watercolor landscape. So the landscape that I have chosen for today, it's called Starry Night. It's in purple, orange, yellow tones. For this project, I am using soft watercolors. So if you look at them, they are very soft and they blend very easy. And also I'm using two brushes. I'm using a flat brush and a small one. So I love flat brushes. These are very good for details, actually easy to work with. So you use this for big surfaces and you also use them for details if you use them on the side of it. So this make very fine lines. Also, I am using the small brush for little details as well. As for paper, I am using cold press paper. This is not very thick, not very thin. I love this this type of paper. So at first, when I first start the work, what I do, I wet the paper. This is fairly easy project. It's very nice for the kids to keep them busy during the summer. If you want to try this with your kids at home or for school projects. So I am going to blend purple and blue here at the beginning of the landscape. It's a bit hard to see for you guys, but I'm going to show you time after time how it looks like. So basically what I'm doing, I'm just spreading the color. This is called wet on wet technique. So I wetted the paper first, and then after the paper, then I go get the color and then spread it and blend it on paper. I'm also going to mix blue and purple here at the beginning. And then blend all the colors together. Watercolor is very nice. It's meant to flow, so you'll see the colors blend together. And that's perfect. That's what we want to achieve with a watercolor project. So I'm going to work on the sides here, and I'm going to leave the center of the project white. I'm not going to touch it very much. So I'm going to get some pink and orange from the bottom of the project. Also, sometimes I know I've noticed kids like to use the brush in this way, and that's fine. In the wide way, wide ways, and that's okay. If they use it on this side of the brush, it's very difficult to blend, so it's better to use it on the thick side. And then I'm going to mix a bit of yellow and orange here for the bottom. As for the colors, I don't have any preferences in what kind of brand or colors that I use. I use generally anything that's easy to work with. I do love I find it easier when the watercolors are soft, because you can find them like hard in palettes, or you can find them soft. I find it easier the soft ones to blend. But the hard ones, the ones that you find in the palettes, they are more resistant to the time. They last longer than the soft ones. I feel like the soft ones, you consume faster, you use them faster. So it's up to you. It's a matter of preference. It depends what you prefer. So you have to try a few of them and then choose the one that's your favorite. So I'm just blending blue, pink, and I'm going down to orange and yellow here. So this is how it looks like so far. It's okay if the water just flows. That's what it's meant to do. So the watercolors are meant to flow and blend together, and that's perfectly fine. And then for the trees here, I love to use the flat brush. So I am going to go this way. So use the tip of the brush to make the spikes. And you can also fill it up with the flat part of the brush. Like I said, this is fairly easy project for the kids to do, and it's easy to keep them occupied during the day. And it's easy to clean, so it doesn't take too much work with cleaning either. So it just washes very nicely off the brushes or from tablecloths. Make sure you use plastic tablecloths because it's easier to clean if you guys are going to do this at home. And I'm going to show you how it looks like in a minute. Basically, that's how it looks like. It's okay if it's flowing here, that's fine. So what you need to do is just move the paper a little bit and just let it dry the way it is. So I'm also going to put just a bit of white here in the center. And then after it dries, then you can put some white paint on top for the stars. And that's how it looks like. So hope you guys like this video. I'm going to do more videos in the future. I'm going to let this dry for now, and I will show you how it looks like at the end. Thank you for joining me today.